Well, let's go back to Venice again and do a sort of Grand Canal, but very diffuse. I'm basing my painting on a Laszlo Ritter painting. I knew Laszlo, I met him a couple of times. He showed me how to do the water in the oil paintings that I did. A very generous man, but alas, he died about 10 years ago, 12 years ago. Painted some wonderful, wonderful paintings. He could paint in any style, a bit like Tom Keating, really, who he knew. Tom Keating was a great art forger. I finally made some money on with Channel 4 documentaries on painting in like Monet and Jonkin and so on. Anyway, I hope I'm going to use quite a bit of dilute PVA glue. When it dries I'll put it in a plastic lid. When it dries, you can peel it off and it's plastic. Well, that's in there. So I'm just going to just sketch out the dome, the Salou. And I'll use a bit of cerulean and a bit of red. So we'll just try and get some sort of. So it'll all be lost and found. Probably could go up about there. And another one here. Use a bit of that as well, a bit of water, and we'll light red and cerulean is a good colour. I'm going to go over all of this. This is just basis of the dome and the buildings and the gondolas this will all be underneath glazes of colour, so let's use a bit of white in that as well. I'll put a sky element over this and you'll see more what I'm sort of trying to do. I'll mix a bit of burnt sienna, sound a bit of that blue, I think. Okay. Clean the brush. And we'll go in with some lim. Plenty of medium. I'll use a bit of ultramarine with the cerulean. A while before you see what I'm trying to do. A misty sort of murky impression. I've primed this board. It's nowhere near as rough as the one I did on Monday. Get that red coming through. So I've painted a red ground. I've got a cup of tea here, so I must drink that. I'll try and do this in one go, but if I get to come up to an impasse, I'll stop the video and start a new one and do it in two parts. You should do this with not olive oil, some alkyd or fast drying linseed oil. It was a linseed mixed with alkyd resin, which made it fast drying, so you could crack on with it, but not as fast as this. This dries very quickly. Got to get that dome right. Okay. Swirling sky, that's what Laszlo did. I'm doing this in the style of one of Laszlo's paintings. But it's the glorious freedom that he painted with. But he used a lot of oil, and paint used to run down the canvas almost. And he was working at that time, and I knew him through the Webster Gallery, selling a lot of finished paintings that I was doing. So I'm using the PVA glue to glaze with. Hands as well. Bit of alizarin in the mix. So I've lost the dome, but that will come back. trying to get the sort of the light sort of swirling around the clouds in the sky. Right, let's go back to the I always use the largest brush I can get away with. Ooh, I accidentally wet my brush into the ultramarine. Just, we're only just going to indicate a horizon. Time in Is it showing up? Yeah, it's coming up. Right, some red and ultramarine. Now, we could put some sort of gondolas in. Need another brush, I think. That one. Just dark. I'm just using blue and red. I'm not going to use any black in this. Oops. And we can lose all these. Going over that now. Change your brush now. I think let's change. I've got this number, oh, what is it, number 10. It's a sable mix. Disappear in there. just painting the cloud around that dome. So get the dome right. Well, spend a little bit of time on the domes. Right, nice pinky stuff coming on there. Loads of medium. As I said, it's a PVA glue. But you've got to keep it fluid. It's only a little painting, it's just a 10 by 8 inches, whatever that is in metric. I mix a bit of alizarin with some cadmium red here. See how quickly you can just change just by you thinning down the paint. But you've got to use loads of the colour. No, loads of the medium. Look, see how liquid that is, but it would dry much lighter, or that milkiness will go out of the colour because it's mostly glue, the whitish glue. Right, now I'll get a smaller rigger, a sprig of tea. My tea goes cold and I know I've been working on the painting too long, so let's just put a bit of detail back now. So all this lost in the murk. Well, hopefully you're lost in the mud. It was easier to do with oil because it stayed open longer. I'll put thin glazes over that as well. I've got to reinstate that, but I want that to dry. So let's just clean that brush and get an inch brush. And with some dark, just red and blue. Change the brush. In the wrong place. See, I want all this to just to be sort of in the shadow. Try and get different effects. Right, now I want to try to bring that cloud or the I'm going to reinstate some of that background. So this is really an exercise in glazing and creating effects in misty, mystery atmosphere. Oops. Brush has fallen apart. And we've got to soften that. Can we do that when it dries a little bit? Just a little fix. Oops, got a bridge there. Don't like that. Quite hard to get a realistic dome. Soften that.
Okay.
Not too much. Want it to show, but I don't want it to be a hard edge. Just a bit of a hard edge there. We just lose that a little bit. I don't want it to show, I don't want it to stand out. Let's get some liquid on there. That bit is all... it's a tricky bit, anyhow. I'm going to put one of Laszlo's little gondoliers in. Put them here. I'm just using a bit of blue neat and a bit of red just to get the Right, let's just put a few flicks and highlights. Can't do much more than that at the moment. I just want to put some lights in. Just some white bits of. Give me a little bit of a reflection. I'm going to give Laszlo quite a bit of credit for this, because it was mainly his view, but I've just done a version of it. Oh, just some bits of red. So I'm going to soften a bit around here now. Just a bit more to it. Nice and loose. And some of this cerulean. Cerulean is a beautiful, beautiful blue. And it works well with mixing with ultramarine. Bit of water there. Alright, let's get some, just a bit of darker cerulean, bit of alizarin. Okay, I haven't got the frames downstairs. I forgot to bring it up. So what I'll try and do is I'll bring you round and see if I can just get rid of some of the margins. Oh, I might know what I might do. Put a mount around it. Pull me a mouse. I've got the frame downstairs. But, probably too big. I might just have to leave it like it is and somewhere. Oh, that's a bit better. Right on. I'm just going to stick it in the mount, so bear with me while I do this, and I can put it up. Problem solved. Oops. There, it's not quite a straight in the mount there, but I'll have to let there go. So there's another little Venice impression. That's all it is. it's just a little bit too obvious, so we'll just take that down a little bit. Bit of white, bit of cerulean, plenty of medium. Bit of water in there. Yeah, that's a bit better, I think. Oh, no, it's not. Am I doing the right side? This is just a little bit too even, so let's just go in. Let's just lose some of that a little bit. That's a bit better. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed that. One session. I'll put it in a mount, in its frame in a minute, and photograph it and post it on Facebook. That really needs to be just a little bit lighter in here. It's just... something like that. It's just, could do this forever, but right. Okay. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.